All right, friends, so we are here to work on our learning target of I can interpret motion graphs. This is part of our force and motion unit. I know that we have talked about it briefly together, but now we're going to take a deeper dive into looking at these motion graphs and interpreting or understanding them. All right, so when we are doing this, please remember that you can pause and rewind as needed so that you can have appropriate understanding. And of course, make sure that you have something to write on and something to write with. This right here is what we want to go ahead and write down, because this will kind of be like our checklist that you'll use throughout this module to ensure that you have appropriate understanding of these graphs. So when we're looking at a motion graph, we want to look at the title, and then we want to look at the axes, and then we want to ask ourselves what happened. So if I'm looking at this graph right here, let's go ahead and go through those steps. Okay, so I'm going to look at a title, distance walked by student. Okay, so I'm thinking about distance. All right, so I know that. I'm going to look at the axes. Okay, down here is time and up here is distance. Okay, so when I'm thinking about how far he went, that's going to be over here. And then how long it took, I'm going to go over here. All right, so now what happened? All right, so if I'm looking, so he started from here and I notice that he just goes away. He never comes back because we end up here at 22 meters away. Again, I'm looking right here at this axis to find that. So I know he's walking away from where he started from. Okay, I can see that he was walking at a pretty steady pace up here. It took him 4 seconds to go 12 meters. So it took 4 seconds to go 12 meters. If I wanted to go ahead and find out that, I could go ahead, find his speed. I could do the distance over the time to get his speed of 3 meters per second. Pretty fast pace, honestly. As I continue moving on, I notice right here, my distance does not change. So he must have taken a break right here because it's flat. And then we keep on going as he's walking past. I see that he went faster here and he went slower here. And I can tell that because it took me a longer amount of time to go up those two. Versus this only took us a little bit of time to go up 3. All right, let's go ahead and look at another one, thinking about this as well. And then you're going to look at some of your own. So again, we're going to look at the title, look at axes, and ask ourselves what happened. All right, so my title is Position of a Caterpillar. Okay, so I'm thinking about the caterpillar moving. Down here is time again, and over here is position. This time it's in centimeters. All right, what happened? Well, first off, I noticed that he started 1 centimeter away from something because at 0, whenever this all started, he was 1 centimeter away. It looks like we went ahead and took a break at first because my distance doesn't change. So we took a break for 10 seconds. And then between 10 and 30 seconds, he went ahead and started moving. Another break between 30 and 40. And then I see that he went backwards. Okay, so we went from 3 centimeters away to 2 centimeters away. So he started going backwards at this time, not down, but backwards, because we're thinking about this. Because if I was to graph, or if I was to kind of draw this, I'm starting off at this. So here's 1, here's 2, here's 3, here's 4. So first he stays at 1, and then he goes to 2 and 3. Then he takes a break, and then he's going back to 2. That's this part right here. And then he keeps on going to 5. All right, friends, so go ahead and rewind and watch this as much as you need to kind of get into the groove of doing these 3 questions right here. And then when you're ready, go ahead and move to your practice.